All right, everybody, we got a piece of sci-fi royalty coming at you this time. Let's do it. All right, this episode, we got 1955's This Island Earth, true classic. You know the routine, we're going to go to the trailer.
The two of you are beginning a strange journey, a journey that no Earth people have ever undertaken before.
Universal International presents the most startling, the most imaginative and suspenseful science fiction drama ever brought to the screen. You'll marvel at the superior intelligence that unleashes its deadly ray.
Dave! Dave!
Or can kidnap an airplane in flight.
Pulling us up.
Prisoners hurtling through endless space, speeding toward the unearthly furies of a planet gone mad. See sights never before dreamed by man. The battle between guided meteors and deadly rays.
They're gonna hit us! They're gonna hit us!
A planet doomed to destruction. While captive Earth people fight for their lives.
It is indeed typical that you Earth people refuse to believe in the superiority of any world but your own.
Run, Ruth, run!
Okay, this motion picture was directed by Joseph Newman. He directed movies like Red Skies of Montana, Flight to Hong Kong, Abandoned, Dangerous Crossings. He also did the Big Valley TV series and Twilight Zones and some of the Alfred Hitchcock Hour episodes. So he had a long story career, second unit work, stuff like that too. So all that really matters is he did this, and this is enough. Okay, playing Exeter was Jeff Morrow. Jeff Morrow had a pretty long career going on. He did a lot of TV show work back in the day. He did TV shows like The Twilight Zone, Police Story, Daniel Boone, Iron Horse, Perry Mason, The Rifleman, The Virginian. He was on all that stuff. He was also in movies like The Giant Claw. He was in Hour of Decision. He was in Kronos, which was another sci-fi flick. So he had a career kind of in this genre of motion picture and a lot of television work. So, you know, Jeff Morrow, God bless him. Okay, let's keep kicking it. Okay, playing Dr. Ruth Adams was Faith Domergue. She was this incredibly hot brunette actress back in the day. She was in stuff like Voyage to the Prehistoric Planet, It Came from Beneath the Sea, Where Danger Lives, This Island Earth, So Evil, My Sister. She was in a bunch of movies. Gorgeous actress, drop dead to look at. You know, they don't make them like this anymore, folks. I hate to break it to you. I'm just throwing that out there. And she did a great job in this motion picture, too. Played a strong female character that was still drop dead gorgeous and extremely girly to look at. So, great job in this. Let's keep rolling. Okay, playing Cal Meacham was Rex Reason. He was in motion pictures. Obviously, he was in This Island Earth. He was also in The Creature Walks Among Us. He was in stuff like The Badlands of Montana, Raw Edge, Lady Godiva of Coventry. He was on TV shows like Perry Mason and everything like that. He hasn't done anything. His career kind of ended in the 60s. So, you know, he kind of came and went. But did a great job in this in motion picture. And he actually, there's a fun bit of trivia when it comes to The Creature Walks Among Us, and I'll give it to you in just a minute. All right. Playing Dr. Steve Carlson was Russell Johnson. Now, before I get into the list of stuff that he's done, you know and I know the only thing that everybody's going to remember him for was being the professor on Gilligan's Island. He had that run. He did the TV movies, all that kind of crap, where he was always playing the professor. And his comedic timing was great on it. He did a great job. But he was also in a bunch of other motion pictures. He was in stuff like Strange Lady in Town, Many Rivers to Cross, Black Tuesday. But really what he was known for was mostly being a professor. He was in things like, too, like, you know, the Alfred Hitchcock Hour and the Adventures of Rin Tin Tin. So basically he was kind of like an budget motion pictures. And he was a big star on television, within reason, you know, a big star. He was never like the leading man, but he had his job and he did his thing. So, hey man, God bless him for that. I just got to give also a quick shout out to Doug Spencer, who played the monitor in this movie. Because he was also in one of my favorite motion pictures of all time, especially from this genre. He was in The Thing from Another World from 1951. He played Ned, like the reporter guy or anything like that, popping around. So to see him in this motion picture playing this cold, aloof type of alien creature, when he played like this nerdy type of wacky, you know, reporter in The Thing from Another World, showed a nice range of what he could do from the lighthearted and affable to the more dark and mysterious and everything like that. So, Douglas Spencer, hey, wherever you are, God bless. I'm sure you're not here anymore. I mean, it's been forever, but whatever. One of the little things of trivia I wanted to point out in this here, too, is that Rex Reason and Jeff Morrow were also in another motion picture together called The Creature Walks Among Us. And you could see them side by side playing off of each other in that motion picture. And it's just odd that, you know, within a couple years span, you've seen them again playing together in this island Earth. You know, totally different characters and different stuff. But it was like this fun pairing of these two guys. And like, they must have been like, didn't I just work with you? Didn't we just do a movie together? So, fun little bit of trivia. Anyway, let's kick it off. Okay, this motion picture starts out where you see Cal Meacham. He's a scientist. Of course, he's one of those uber cool scientists that when he goes to a meeting, he has to get there by jet fighter, of all things, you know what I mean? But it's on his way to this meeting where he's flying back and he's coming in the tower, and he's kind of like the original Top Gun type guy. Everybody's in the tower, they're like, hey, Cal, welcome back. And he strafes the tower and sends everybody ducking and running for cover, and it's like, oh, that Cal. But then something happens. His airplane, or jet, his jet goes into like a stall. He can't figure out what's wrong. He loses all power. He loses all control. And it's just before he's ready to crash, and everybody's in horror because the great Cal Meacham is about to die. His plane starts growing green, and he can't figure it out. And all of a sudden, it levels off, and it starts cruising along like nothing's nothing, and it lands perfectly. His assistant runs out to them, and he says, hey, Cal, I know you're going to think I'm nuts, but right before you were about to crash, your plane started growing glowing green, and then it just landed like nothing was nothing. And Cal says, yeah, man, I should be dead right now. There's something seriously wrong here. But whatever. Let's get back to work. So they go back to the lab. Immediately he hits the front door, and Cal just starts, without thinking, without putting his coat down, for God's sakes, he just goes into an experiment, clicks a button, and starts running the thing. I guess that's how it works in these old-time labs, I don't know. And the experiment blows up this transformer. And he says, hey, put a new transformer in. And his assistant goes, well, I ordered one, but all they sent me was these little teeny beads, little pieces of glass. And he's like, these things can't conduct any current. These things are a joke. They take them over and they run them through a machine. And the machine says these things can handle like 33,000 volts. Nothing on planet Earth can handle that kind of voltage going through it. So they call up the guys whoever the hell sends them the parts. You know what I'm trying to say. And they're like, we never sent you no parts. We never sent anything to you. And they're like, what? How can this be? This makes no sense. At that moment, this book shows up, and he signs for it, and they're in there, and they're checking everything out, and all of a sudden in the book it's like, how to build this thing called Interocitor! That's the goddamn thing. So anyway, he's looking at this book, him and his assistant, his name is Joe, by the way, I keep calling him assistant, but I guess I should call him by his name, Joe. And they're looking at this book, and they're like, what the hell is this thing? This doesn't make any sense. And it suddenly dawns on them, like, hey, why don't we order the parts for this thing from the same place that we were ordering the parts that never came from the original place, and they sent us these beads. Let's just see. And they do. And before you know, poof, there's hundreds and thousands of parts there just to build this thing they don't even know what it is, an interocitor. So they take all the parts, they hang out, they put all the crap together, they build an interocitor. They turn it on, and what do they see? They see the face of Exeter sitting there, and he's talking to them. Hey, congratulations on putting together an interocitor. Only a few people could put together an interocitor. This is amazing that you pulled off an interocitor. Then Exeter says, I'm going to send an airplane for you tomorrow. I want you to get on board. I want you to come and see what we have to offer. Come work for me on this great plan. Well, Meacham doesn't know what the hell he's talking about. He goes, I don't know if I'm going to get on this plane. He goes, you could be a whack job. I don't know who you are. And he goes, oh, your curiosity, doctor, you most certainly will arrive. Son of a bitch, the next day, it's a foggy day out, can't see anything. The plane lands. When the plane lands, guess what? There's no pilot. This thing is kind of like being guided by a mini interocitor, I guess. I don't know what the hell that whatever. I don't know. It's flying by itself. So he hops on board, it takes off, and it lands at this ranch. That's where he meets Dr. Ruth. A former love interest, by the way, who can't show that she's a former love interest. But she's like, oh, you know, you must have me mixed up with somebody else, doctor. I don't know who you're talking about, but it ain't me. They go back, and he meets Exeter. And Exeter's got this big cranium, this messed up forehead, which for some reason nobody seems to acknowledge in this motion picture that much. I mean, you'd be thinking, like, everybody would be like, why does this guy have a ginormous head? Why does this man have a gigantic head? A gigantic head. I don't want to give too much more of the way of this motion picture about who Exeter is and what he wants. All I will say is that Exeter needs scientists from Earth to help out his home planet. I mean, it's not giving anything away saying this guy's an alien, for Christ's sakes. Look at him. That's why, look at him. Anyway, they need help from the scientists of Earth to help his home world. What lengths will they go to pull this off? What will they do to get that kind of help? Will they make you go against your will? Will you help willingly? Are they all good aliens? Are they all bad aliens? That's for you to find out when you go check out this motion picture. Okay, this island Earth is one of those motion pictures I consider from the glory days of science fiction, when you're talking things like The War of the Worlds, This Island Earth, Forbidden Planet. These special effects were very good and very solid, yes, a little bit dated, but they still hold up. The stories were fun, they were exciting, they were well acted. Yeah, there was always that guy in them, you know what I mean, that head guy, you know, whether it was the doctor from War of the Worlds, or Cal Meacham in this, or whether it was Leslie Nielsen in Forbidden Planet. You know that kind of guy who's just that kind of guy, that kind of guy. But you sit there and you watch these motion pictures, and it's just one of those great times to be had. The effects are cool, the stories are cool, all the actors are cool, the guys are guys, the girls are girls, and they're hot, they're strong, they're intelligent, they're just on the same playing field as the guys, but they're women. They're, you know, women, before they tried to make them look like dudes to prove that they could do dude shit. Yeah. Anyway, you get a shot, check out this island Earth. 1955 classic. If you put in any of the movies of its time and you watch it, you will say this is right up there with it. I'm going to give one more thing away. They might not spend as much time in space as you think they're going to do, or they might not spend enough time on the other planet as you think they're going to do. It mostly takes place on Earth for most of the story. You know what I mean? It's not one of those, you know, super sci-fi, everything is out there. But you got fun aliens, you got the big mutant, you've got all this kind of cool shit going on inside of it that just results in a good time, a good popcorn time, a good Saturday afternoon to watch. Well done, well constructed, well directed, well acted from a golden age of motion pictures. Everybody, go check out This Island Earth. All right, everybody, gotta go, gotta run. This is a quickie. Catch you next time. Bye.